Welcome to the Audiophile Barista Room Tour series, where my wonderful subscribers share their rooms with you. And today our hosts are André and Judith. Now, before we get into the video, I must say that this is not a new room. You already have seen this room in tour number 4. But André's system has had such a complete transformation since that episode that we decided to do a new tour. So under COVID rules, I took the train to his house to film his new system. This also gave me the opportunity to meet André and his wonderful wife Judith. These are two of the nicest people I've ever met, and where our hobby is mostly a male thing and partners are more or less supportive of the hobby, Judith is actually very much involved in the building and enjoyment of the system, so that was a very nice departure of the stereotypical image of our hobby. So this is where the voiceover part stops and the actual video starts. Enjoy! Okay, welcome to the Audiophile Barista. Today we are visiting André. André is one of the subscribers for a long time now, and he was as a friendly man as he is. He invited me into his home and having a look at his system. Now, as you can see, this is a very imposant, impressive system. It is minimalistic in the sense that it has a source, an amplifier, and that's it, and two big loudspeakers that we are going to tell you all about. There is also a nice CD collection that we're going to show you, but this is the Audiophile Barista, so one thing we need to check out first is what is the coffee game here. So let's have a look. Okay, so this impressive machine, this is the coffee game here in the house. André is going to tell you what they're doing with this machine.
We can put a pot of fresh coffee, normal coffee here in Holland.
Yeah, filter coffee.
Filter coffee, and we can also make a nice espresso.
Ah, so it's a double machine.
It's a double machine.
And for milk? Are you using the steam?
You can use it, but we don't use it.
You don't use the steam wand?
No.
And the reason for that is?
Too much work.
Too much work. Okay. Well, maybe I should make a video about using a steam wand, because I think it is not too much work. So this is the coffee machine. And of course, this is already improved because they are drinking coffee and not only tea. So let's move on to the system. Okay, so of course I understand that you want to check out the big system, but this guy André, he has the best wife, because he is not only allowed to have this big system in his house. If we turn around, there's also room for a TV. There used to be some loudspeakers over here. Temporarily, they are not. They even have their movie posters on the wall. So these people know how to enjoy life and use these things. Over here you can see the CD. We're going to dive into that. But for now, I want to say that I appreciate very much to have your room with one side going to listen to music, and only by turning around, you'll be watching TV. Now, maybe he is going to combine TV with his big system, but for now, I can appreciate that people know what they like and enjoy it. And there is another appearance from the cat. So because of the backlight, the colors are a little bit washed out, but at least you can see everything that we have here. So I'm going to invite André and ask him, what is it that you have here? And why do you have this? So, well, this is the best visible with this lighting. So, what is it that you have here? Because these things are huge.
This is a loudspeaker built by a good friend of mine. It's a backloaded horn with a 40 centimeter full range driver, which is a rendement of 102 dB, so easy to drive.
Yeah.
And the super tweeter is a Kenwood super tweeter.
And this will get another housing soon.
Soon, yes.
Because this thing is Just recently here, right?
Yeah.
How long do you have it?
The speakers, just a week.
Just a week?
Just a week.
And he has been painting them. Yep. He is busy making them more beautiful, which is a challenge with a loudspeaker like this. So what is the slot over here?
That's the baseboard.
That is the baseboard. So inside here, backloaded horn, meaning that there is a long way for the air to go and come out at the front and give you crazy bass.
When you crank it up, it's crazy bass.
Yeah, and that's what you want.
Yes.
Okay, but still clean bass?
Clean bass, low, deep, fast, but clean.
This is interesting, and you guys, you won't believe, when you come in here, you will be astounded when you think, well, how big these things are. But I've been here now for a few hours, we have been chatting, and they get smaller and smaller. You get used to it very easily. Okay, so where most people have big systems, multiple amplifiers, CD streamers, you are the purist. You have a CD player and you have an amplifier and that is it. So what about the CD player? What is it that you have here?
It's a Philips CD player. It's a CD670. It's an old one, but it plays very, very nice. I love the sound of the player.
Yeah, and you go analog out to
analog
the...
Analog out to the amplifier, and the amplifier is a knob sound. JLH96. It's 2x10W class A. And plays wonderful.
Of course, here you see the heatsink because of the class A, and I believe this is double mono.
Double mono, okay. Yes.
So the separate systems for left and for right. You changed your rack.
Correct. I got a wooden rack, and this is a steel rack, which sounds better.
And you even noticed that it sounds better?
I noticed that it sounds better.
Okay,
absolutely.
Now, I can already see the comments in the comment section, but I don't care. I think that is something that plays a role. So what difference do you?
Cleaner sound. And even with the spikes underneath the CD player and the amplifier,
oh, right.
That improves the sound big.
Okay.
I know there are people who don't believe that, but I say try it out. It will shock you.
Yeah, this is always what amazes me, that people will say it doesn't work. And when I ask, did you ever try it? Well, of course not. Okay. But it's glad to hear that you do think there is a difference, because I had my rack made. You all have seen the video about my rack, and I invested because I think these things absolutely make a difference. I like this rack. It has a very nice 70s style. Great stuff. Hi there. Apparently the cat wants to be part of it. You think she likes the music?
She likes the music.
She likes the music.
But when the bass is too loud, she is away.
She is gone. Yeah. Ah, okay. Yeah. So that is a thing. Now, André, we had the room tour. I believe you were the second one that I did a room tour of. And everything, except for the amplifier, everything has changed. And throughout the year we have had a lot of contact via email, where you kept me updated on the changes. And at one point I thought, well, I have to go there because nothing is the same anymore. So what were the main reasons that you wanted to change?
I want to experience music more, and my previous system was not to my satisfaction. I missed some things in the recordings. So a week ago, a good friend of mine, he said, try these speakers. And I was blown away. They perform wonderful.
And what do you mean by wonderful? Because everybody has his own preferences in music, of course.
I'm in this hobby for about 20 years. And this is the first speaker I have that is, to me, perfect.
That's a big statement. Perfect.
For what I like to hear from a speaker.
Yeah. And what is the most important thing that you like to hear from a speaker?
Clarity. Musical.
Yeah.
And realistic sound.
And I have been listening to this thing, guys, and realistic sound is absolutely what it does. It has a very comfortable sound. It's very easy, not pushy, and it puts a nice big scene in front of you. The only thing at the moment is that these things are big, and where you are listening, what they normally say, put your loudspeakers at ear level. Ear level would be there, but then it is a little bit the, let me go back a little bit. So when you are sitting here, these loudspeakers, these drivers are quite way above your ears. Maybe 50 centimeters, something like that.
Yeah.
I don't know exactly. Which makes the sound, when you're sitting here, you should be having the singer somewhere at this level, and it's now a little bit higher. It's not a problem, it's just something that normally you have a different perspective when you're listening music at ear level. The singer will be at ear level, and that is just different this time. But there may be a possibility to lower these loudspeakers a little bit, and that's something that he is going to play with. But when you sit here and you listen to it, it's not a problem. It's something that you observe, but it does not get in the way of enjoying the music. Okay, and then of course there is the most important part of this hobby, otherwise nothing happens, and that is the music. So this is the CD collection from André. Is this your complete CD collection?
This is my complete CD collection.
You just told me that the cupboard was much more filled with CDs, but you picked out a lot of them to create some space and put away some of the CDs that you never listen to anymore.
Correct, correct.
And where did you put those CDs that you did away?
I gave them away.
Yeah, that's how it should be, guys.
I make somebody else very happy with the CDs.
You know, music should be shared.
Absolutely.
Because I am grateful to André, so I picked up a few soundtrack CDs, and because I knew that he liked those very much. So André, I've been looking through your CD collection, and this is not a hard rock CD cupboard. This is a little bit of everything. There's jazz, there's classical music, there is some guitar music, there is some voices, blues
soundtracks.
Soundtracks is one of your big things.
Synthesizer.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very fond of synthesizer music. I love Irish music. A little bit of
Irish music.
Test CDs.
Yeah, of course.
Test CDs and how do you call it? The easy listening.
Easy listening.
Van Morrison, big fan of Van Morrison.
Ah, okay.
Dire Straits, big fan of Dire Straits. Some Pink Floyd.
Mm-hmm, of course. Okay, so let's see if we can inspire some of the viewers and pick out some of your favorite CDs and tell us a little bit about why you think those are good for you.
I'm a great fan of jazz music. So we played it with Ivor, Ella Fitzgerald.
Yes, this is the song that I just heard.
Yeah.
And this is just beautiful. It gives this 70s vibe, 60s vibe, completely here in the room. Very nice.
She's got a beautiful voice.
Absolutely.
For the jazz, how is that? For the listeners who like jazz very much,
mm-hmm.
I've got one recording you must try. It's from Tsuyoshi Yamamoto, Autumn in Seattle. He's a Japanese jazz pianist, and he plays with such a feeling, it's incredible. You've got to hear this CD.
Yeah, and for those audiophiles out there, you probably noticed that this is a film production. These things are not cheap, and these things are very good. He got this as a birthday present.
Correct.
Because this is not something that you just buy off the shelf. You really have to invest in this, but it pays.
It pays a lot.
Ah, okay.
So this is mostly is the instrumental jazz. This is also a very wonderful CD.
What do we have here?
Ola Kijilo.
Oh yeah.
It's a choir. I think it was Libera who sings on it, boys choir. This is a very wonderful CD.
A nice Decca recording.
Nice, very nice recording.
Mostly very warm sounding.
Warm sounding, and on my loudspeakers, the choir is standing in the living room.
Ah, great. Okay, so show us some more.
Then we go classic. Then here we have the soundtrack of the movie The Pianist. It's also an HD CD. Very, very nice recording. And beautiful piano music from the movie.
From the movie, and this is the, if you turn it around, let me show you the HD focus, HD mastering. These are special CDs, and if your system is up to it, they will show you why it is interesting to look out for discs like this.
Absolute.
Okay, can we do one more?
You can do one of my favorites. Is this soundtrack? It's from a Disney movie, The Crimson Ring, The Life of the Flamingos. It's the cinematic orchestra, and this music soundtrack is wonderful.
And why is it wonderful?
The recording, how do you say it? If you see the documentary about the flamingos, you hear the music, you want to have this CD.
Okay, and that's how you got it.
That's how I got it, yeah.
Okay, perfect. Okay guys, this was just to inspire you to play some music that you maybe have never heard of. And this is the CD collection. Now this video is definitely going to be demonetized because of the music clips. So if you like this and you want to help me out, give this video a like and subscribe. Now let's play some more music.
There'll be no night.
Okay, and so we come to the end of room tour number 6. I want to thank André and Judith for their hospitality. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.